I'm Dr. Aruna Mohan, and today I'm discussing with you certain aspects of reproduction in organisms. Before we enter into details, I would like to tell you why reproduction is so important for any organism. We know about other systems like digestive, respiratory system, excretory system, nervous system. Of course, every system is important, but in today's context, we would like to discuss why reproduction is so important. We all are aware of the fact that reproduction becomes important for continuation of species. What do I mean by this sentence? I mean that any organism, small or big, simple or complicated, single-celled or multicellular organism, each organism wishes to survive on this earth and wants to leave progeny behind him. That is the only way for the continuation of a species. Students, you are aware of the fact that evolution took place, and from amoeba, gradually by the process of evolution, man is made. And today we consider ourselves at the top of evolutionary tree. This has happened in steps. This is a different story. Evolution is a different story, which we might discuss in some other program. But in today's program, we are concentrating on reproduction. Now, from amoeba came out bigger organisms, and from that still bigger organisms than fishes, frogs, reptiles on one side, birds, and on the other side, mammals. All these animals through which we have evolved are still available on earth. If from fishes frogs are made, that does not mean that fishes have disappeared. Or from frogs or from amphibians reptiles are made, that will not mean that frogs will disappear. That means every step is preserved by nature on earth. And how it is preserved? By process of reproduction. Reproduction goes on. The main purpose of reproduction is to produce its own kind. And there are so many methods by which this is done by different organisms. Let me now tell you the major types of reproduction. There are two major types, if we categorize them. One category is asexual reproduction, and other category is sexual reproduction. In today's program, we are concentrating on asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction normally takes place in lower organisms, but now it is made use even in higher animals for different purposes. Naturally, it occurs in microscopic animals and slightly bigger animals. One way of asexual reproduction is fission, that is division, which can be simple binary fission, can be transverse binary fission, can be longitudinal binary fission, and it can even be multiple fission. Fission means division, and binary means two, and multiple will mean more than two. I am going to discuss all these in detail little later. Other way of asexual reproduction is budding. There can be exogenous budding, or there can be internal buds. It will happen in different way in different organisms. And there is one more way called fragmentation, where asexual reproduction is taking place by fragmentation and finally leading to regeneration. Let us now discuss each one of these steps in detail. In this particular slide, I am trying to explain simple binary fission in amoeba. Why I am calling it simple, I will explain. First, I will tell you the meaning of binary fission. Binary fission means dividing into two. Now, what happens in case of amoeba? The only way it simply reproduces is that it will divide into two. The parent cell will divide into two daughter cells. Now they will be called daughter amoebae or daughter cells. The process is that amoeba will elongate a bit. As you know, amoeba is single celled, and inside that one single cell body there is one nucleus which is the center of the cell for almost all the important activities. Now when reproduction starts, this nucleus will elongate along with the elongation of the body and divide into two. You can see starting from left there is amoeba, now it is elongated and now nucleus started dividing, and in the fourth from the left the nucleus has almost gone to two extremes. Please remember, my dear students, that in any fission or this kind of division, nucleus divides first and cytoplasm, or in this case the body of amoeba, will divide later. So once nucleus divides, it will reach to two extreme ends, and now cytokinesis will take place, and that will result one cell giving rise to two cells. Each half is having one nucleus. We can call them daughter amoebae, which will grow to the normal size or adult size of amoeba. Why we are calling it simple binary fission? As I told you, binary fission means once dividing into two, binary. Simple because this cytokinesis, the division of cytoplasm, that particular division can be in any plane. Any plane means it is simple. When it is in a particular plane, then we give the name depending upon the plane. So this is the simple binary fission, and very good example is amoeba. We go forward with other kind of binary fissions. In this slide you are seeing paramecium on the left side and planaria on the right side. These are also single cell organisms, and they also divide by binary fission, one into two. But this is called transverse binary fission. I will give you the reason little later. Now in paramecium we have two nuclei. One is mega, one is micro, or one is micro and other is macro. Both the nuclei will elongate along with the elongation of the body, and they divide into two. Gradually they will reach to two different poles of the body. You can see fourth diagram from the left side. And once nuclear division has taken place, then there will be cytoplasmic division. In relation to the axis of the body, the division is always transverse in this case. And hence, we will call it transverse binary fission. One dividing into two, binary fission. And because cytoplasmic division is transverse to the axis of the body, hence transverse binary fission. The result is formation of two daughter paramecia. Again, this is a very simple way of reproduction which is taking place in paramecium. On the right side of this slide you can see planaria. Again, it is also example of transverse binary fission, but there is some addition to be told. You can see in the diagram that planaria elongated, the nucleus also elongated, nucleus divided, and then the body also divided in a transverse plane. And now the lower body is not having head and upper body is not having tail. Now upper half will form the tail and lower half will form the head. You can see the rightmost diagram on the slide, the head is formed. So this is how one planaria is divided into two. Again it is binary fission, and again it is transverse binary fission because cytoplasmic division is transverse to the axis of the body. Now I would like to explain, my dear students, the longitudinal binary fission, and I have taken Euglena as an example. You all know, students, that Euglena is also single-celled organism and it has one flagella. Now, when it undergoes reproduction by binary fission, then first flagella divides. In fact, flagella does not divide. You can see two flagella. So, flagella has longitudinally divided into two flagella, and then nucleus will divide, and then body will divide. Body will divide longitudinally in relation to the axis of Euglena. You can see in the first slide from the left, the first diagram, there is Euglena with single flagella. Then second one, there are two flagella. In the third, on the first line, you can see nucleus dividing. Then the lower line on the left side, you can see the cytoplasm has started dividing. And on the right side of the lower line, you can see that Euglena has divided into two halves by longitudinal division, each having nucleus and a flagella. So now we have two daughter Euglena. Why we call it longitudinal binary fission? Because the fission was okay, binary fission, one dividing into two, but it was longitudinal to the axis of the body of Euglena when it came to cytoplasmic division. We have discussed simple binary fission, transverse binary fission, longitudinal binary fission. This is the example of budding. As I told you, that budding is one mode of asexual reproduction. You can see in Hydra, which is a multicellular organism, on the lower side one bud appears by simple amite, by simple mitosis. It grows, develops tentacles, and separated from the body. And once it is separated from the body, it will lead a simple, separate, independent life, and now it is a daughter Hydra. So this is reproduction, asexual reproduction by budding, and this is exogenous budding because budding is outside the body. I will also give you the example of internal bud. I will give example of spongilla here, where the parent body will secrete special cells which are enveloped in a covering, and now this group of cell will develop into an individual. Since it is inside the body, we call it internal buds. Now, there is one more way of reproduction, asexual reproduction, fragmentation. If body is divided into several fragments, each fragment will develop into full individual. This is also called regeneration. It also happens in Hydra. You take any part of the body of Hydra, put it separately in a culture medium, it develops into full Hydra. What we speak of one part, you grind Hydra into 100 pieces and each piece will give rise to one Hydra. It is called regeneration or reproduction by fragmentation. So with this, I have explained you different modes of asexual reproduction in organisms. I hope, my dear students, you have understood it nicely and will practice your, you will do revision with this. Thank you.